Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1701, 26 by 26 letters, no repeats, impossible. All right, well, this is going to make sense if you've been watching all week, otherwise it's not. Yesterday, I'm trying to get a 26 by 26 grid of letters where there's no repeats going across the rows. That was easy. We did that on Tuesday, but also no repeats going down the columns. And I did some math yesterday that convinced me that there's no way that this would happen. Even if we had 407 septillion rows in Excel, we would still run out of row 24 since we only have a million rows in Excel to list the possible alternatives. I only got through row 11. So I said, all right, let me just try and write a macro that will fill in the next row. Right. And so here's what we have. Here's the letters we've chosen so far. And we have a grid down here. How many times does this letter appear in this column? Just a simple little COUNTIF. So we're counting, you know, basically it's either going to be 0 or 1 because we're not allowed to have any repeats, right? And then I built this little grid, and this was actually used for yesterday's macro. If the letter is still valid for this column, put the letter, otherwise a number, and I put a unique number because when I was auto-filtering yesterday, I needed to be able to have that macro work, which is a long story that we don't need to get into today. And then we're working on row 12, and of course, for the letter A, there's 15 places where it can go because we've already placed 11 letters, so there's 15 places left, which, you know, sounds really obvious. But what's interesting is once we choose a place for the letter A, well, that knocks a few of these others down to 14. All right. And once we choose a place for the letter B, it might knock some of these down to 13. So what I realized is we have to look for the ones that have the fewest number of choices and solve that one first. Now, the first pass through, it's always going to be A that we're going to solve, but you know, then it might be more or something like that. So let's come up here and I'll run my macro, next row, and bam, it just filled it in. All right, so yesterday, brute force, million rows and all these auto filters, and hey, the macro just works, next row. A little bit slower that time, but it got it. And there it got it. And there it got it. Oh no, it didn't. All right, so in row 15, there was a blank there, and I was having it display a message saying, hey, no luck, you're in trouble. But once I got that, I tried to run it again, and generally, it worked. So it filled in row 16, filled in row 17, filled in row 18. Just looking for places to put the letters, attacking the letters that have the fewest possible locations first. And I discovered, so like right here, there were two that didn't work, but that's okay. When we get one that doesn't work, we just try again, and it works the second time, right? So generally it works, and sure enough, yesterday I said we would be out of possibilities by now, but clearly my math yesterday was wrong, because there we just solved it. So I saved this one and said I'm going to send this to Chris, and then you know, I started all over. I ran it all again, and then I realized, well, wait a second, I don't need to be sitting here pressing next row, I can just have a macro that runs next row repeatedly, and watch this, the whole thing is going to take about 30 seconds, which makes that whole process that I went through yesterday seem completely insane, because to do the auto filters took me a few hours, initially doing things manually, and then realizing that was never going to work, and writing the macro to do it. But here, you know, simply by just throwing this, you know, hey, let's look for a random place, and if it doesn't work, well, that's okay, we'll try that row over. It is consistently solving it over and over and over again. Now, I haven't checked to see if any of them are the same. There's no way that any of these are the same. I've generated, you know, 30 or 40 of them so far. I'm guessing I could continue to do this all day and generate new 26 by 26 grids that are completely unique. So, interesting question. When Chris sent this in, Chris actually started out saying 26 by 26 by 26. Chris wanted 26 grids that never repeat. I said, well, there's absolutely no way that is ever going to happen. But clearly, it's possible to do the 26 by 26 with no repeats all the way through. Here, let's just take a look at our formulas down here. What we should see is all ones, no twos, no zeros. And yep, just working like a charm. So there you go, a 26 by 26 grid, no repeats across the rows, no repeats down the columns. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for sticking with it all week. This problem solved by Chris. We finally have the solution. So we'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.